Tom, these newly released documents include letters from attorneys requesting an investigation into Scott Farah's dealings that date back to the 1990s. In 2007, the Bureau of Securities Regulation was even able to recoup $1 million that investors thought they'd lost. But what so many people want to know is, why did it take so long to shut this business down? Today we got some insight.
This stack of correspondence goes back more than 10 years, with various attorneys asking repeatedly for someone at the state level to investigate financial resources and Scott Farah. The security regulators looked at financial resources records and saw mortgage loans, so they say it was out of their arena.
In this case, what we're trying to verify is whether we're talking about promissory notes that are basically part of a mortgage. Generally, we don't get involved with mortgages, and generally that is overseen by the banking department.
The Banking Commission says their role is to protect consumers who take out mortgage loans, and there were zero complaints from borrowers.
Our jurisdiction only goes to residential mortgages, that's homes, and it is only the whole mortgage broker law is aimed at protecting the borrower from problems.
It was the Banking Commission, though, that finally initiated an examination of the mortgage company's records that led to the closure of Financial Resources Mortgage in October. Now both state agencies, along with the U.S. Attorney and the Securities and Exchange Commission, are working together trying to determine who has jurisdiction.
The next step is a bankruptcy hearing this Thursday, 2:30, at the U.S. Bankruptcy Court on Elm Street in Manchester. It's an open hearing where investors can get information on payments and recovery of assets. Live in the studio tonight, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.